a group with a minister, Mother, usually a polite, musical, sane human being. Mother was mentally unhinged by the announcement of the body of the girl. I don't mean she looked unhappy, to the contrary. She was overcome with joy, and she just about succeeded in overcoming everybody else with her joy.
Nobody knew it, but this lady waved the way for the script that went out with Cecil B. DeMille's approval. Royal wedding fit for a princess bride. Father bride was afraid. For the moment.
She has 7 months to work, and no detail was left to chance or human error. Everything that could be engraved was engraved. There were teeth, and showers,
and dinners.
An 18-piece brass instrument ensemble was engaged.
The bride would remember the minister only 3 times, while the mother's bride was in his office more completely.
Not only were the bridesmaids' outfits made to order, but the tuxedos for the grooming men were bought, not rented by anyone, bought. And if all wasn't enough, the engagement ring was returned to the jeweler for a larger scope, quite too specialized for the MLTV. When I say this lady came unhinged, I mean unhinged.
Juggernaut of faith rolled down the road in the final hour of man.
Guests in formal attire packed the church.
Enough candles were lit to bring daylight back to the evening.
The choir loft the organ for Gus Gray music.
And the night of MLTV closed down the aisle, the graveyard of Opportunity Battery. Never has she taken her seat with more satisfaction. She took it.
She glowed.
Beamed.
Smiled.
And sighed. The music softened. And 9. Count them. 9 chiffon-laced bridesmaids lockstep down the aisle.
While the groom and his men marched into place.
The wedding march spouted from the orchestra. Here comes the bride. Preceded by 4 mini princesses chunking flower petals, and 2 other bearers, 1
for each bear. The congregation rose and turned in anticipation.
Oh, girl.
Ah, bride. She didn't
pass
for hours.
It's Erica. Sam's a lucky guy.
Left alone with the father and the church while March of Maids went on and on. She wandered up and down the tables laden with gourmet goodies and sampled first the little pink, yellow, and green mints, and then picked through the bowls of chestnuts and pecans.
Followed by a cheese ball or 2.
Savoy
a handful of glazed almonds, a little box of some frilly toothpicks stuck in it,
a couple of shrimps, blanketed bacon,
and a cracker.
Hi.
We're back today.
To wash all this down, a glass of pink champagne. Her father did. Her nurse.
What you noticed as the bride stood in the doorway was not her dress, but her face. White. For what was walking down the aisle was a little grenade with a pin pulled out. The bride threw up. Just as she passed by her mother.
Again, pipes her up. We don't mean some polite old lady like her and then there's just really no good word for it. She holds the front of the chancel. Two bridesmaids, the minister, the groom, and the groomsman. I'm quite sure of the details. Leave it all on tape. 3 cameras for it. The bride and father did.
Having scorched from her champagne in the last of her meetings, the bride and the father's
arms,
and
the groom and head off
through the
gate.
Who's
the
doctor function?
And
the mother
of
the bride closed
clothes
over
her
cap. There was
a
fire trail, then
and there,
that
only the
marshal
could
stop.
Groomsmen
rushed
about a room. Many princess flower girls squawked. Bridesmaids saw.
And people with weak stomachs headed their next door. The smell of fresh scratching dripping across the church.
Only a couple of words came to mind. One was the mother of the groom.
There was the father of the bride.
What happened next? Well, we all fight to real life. The guests were invited to return to the reception hall, although they did not eat or drink as much as they might have on different circumstances. The bride was consoled, cleaned up, fitted out with a bridesmaid's dress, and hugged and kissed a lot by the groom. She'll always love him for that. When he said provide everywhere, he meant it. The cast was reassembled where he left off. A single flute played a
quiet air. The words were spoken, and the deed was done. Everyone cried, like you're supposed to do at weddings, mostly because the groom held the bride in his arms the entire time. And no groom ever kissed his bride more tenderly.